The Antec Storm T3 120mm is a fan suitable for chassis use where high airflow is desired instead of high static pressure, which is ideal for cooling solutions. This is why Antec included the PWM case fan description in the product's model number. The Antec Storm T3-120 achieves a gold airflow rating in the Cybernetics PHY scale and a silver static pressure rating. Antec sent me the 3 fan package. The box features a photo of the fan on the front, a description of its features around the back, and the fan specifications on another side. The fan has 7 large blades to produce more airflow. The larger and more the blades, the wider the moving surface area that interacts with the air. Hence, the fan pushes more air. Speed and blade angle also affect airflow. Moreover, Antec states that the blades have 25% increased thickness for increased performance and minimized vibrations. The fan is 30mm wide, so it is larger than the standard 120mm fans. Since it is destined for chassis use, the increased width won't be a problem. On the corners, it has rubber pads on both sides to reduce vibrations and noise. The fan's cable has an extra female connector, allowing you to daisy chain several fans using the same mainboard header. Be careful not to overdo it, though, as most mainboard 4-pin PWM headers cannot handle more than 1 amp, and the thin fan power cables cannot handle higher currents. So, even if the header could deliver more power, the fan cables cannot handle it. I use a fan performance measurement apparatus to evaluate cooling fans. This is a highly sophisticated instrument made in Taiwan by Longwin. Besides the Longwin machine, I also use a Heyman echoic chamber and a highly sophisticated and super expensive noise analyzer by Bruhl & Kjær to get accurate noise measurements. The fan's maximum speed is lower than the middle of the corresponding graph, while its airflow is notably higher. However, its static pressure drops lower. Lastly, given its speed, the fan's power consumption is low enough. The fan's noise is low enough at full and 70% of its maximum speed. 10 to 30% fan speed. Ignore the 50 Hz noise from the mains grid. The next standout frequency is at 160 Hz. 35% fan speed, peak frequency 160 Hz. 50% fan speed, peak frequency 400 Hz. 70% fan speed, peak frequency 400 Hz. 100% fan speed, peak frequency 800 Hz. I have recorded the signals, but please keep in mind that I've enabled automatic gain control, AGC, to make it easier for you to reproduce them. Normalized noise tests, 20 decibels noise output, low speed, average airflow, low static pressure, low power consumption. 25 decibels noise output, low speed, average airflow, low static pressure, low power consumption. 30 decibels noise output, average speed, average airflow, low static pressure, average power consumption. 35 decibels noise output, low speed, average airflow, low static pressure, low power consumption. Advertised versus real performance. In this table, anything in red means bad news, while the blue fonts are good. As far as I remember, this is the first fan to provide a highly accurate noise reading. Unfortunately, this is not the case for the performance numbers, airflow and static pressure, where the readings I got were notably lower than the claimed ones. I received several requests to review the Antec Storm T3-120, and thankfully the brand responded quickly and sent me samples. The product scores well in terms of build quality, and I was impressed to finally find a product with highly accurate noise measurement information. However, this was not the case for the performance numbers, airflow and static pressure, which were notably lower than the claimed ones. Let's now look at 25 dB noise normalized performance. I chose 25 dB because it is low enough not to annoy most users and high enough to allow for speeds that offer decent airflow and static pressure. The fan's airflow is around the middle of the pack, while its static pressure is low. I expected higher performance from a 30mm thick fan, which has an advantage over thinner ones because it has room for the stronger motor and blades with increased surface area. Given its build quality, the product's price is reasonable at around $11 per fan or $34 for the 3-pack bundle. Nonetheless, you can get a 5-pack bundle of the Arctic P12 Max fans at only $36, $7.2 per piece, with the P12 offering slightly lower airflow at 25 decibels, but notably higher static pressure. Before investing in new cooling solutions, read my best cooling fans article on hwbusters.com to compare all alternative fan offerings. You can also find the review on the same site.